Now, whichever I am talking about, that what is the uses of the is_alive method and join method. Now, I have already discussed that is_alive method is used to know that the thread is alive or not. If the thread is alive, then is_alive method will return true. Otherwise, the is_alive method will return false. And in case of join method, if there is two thread running at the same time and one thread use the join method, then the particular thread executions will be continued, and the other thread, whichever thread uses the join method, its execution will be continued, and the other thread, whichever is executing, its execution will be stopped until whenever the thread which use the join method, which user join method completed its task, then the other thread execution will be started. So join method is basically, if a thread uses the join method, then the execution of the other threads will be stopped. And whenever the thread which executed this join method, or we can say this represents the join method, it's completed its own task, after that, the other thread's execution will be started. This is the join method, main join method example. So here you can see in this programming environment, I have used a thread class, our user defined thread class, that is class thread one, which is extending the predefined thread class. And inside this public void run method in patient, and in this public void run method, there is for int I equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. The loop is I equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. And in this loop, there is system.out.println, the statement mentioned, that is status equal to is_alive. Means if this thread runs, how many times this loop will run, it will show is_alive will return true. Is_alive will return true status, because this thread is running. If this thread runs, then is_alive method will show true. Otherwise, whenever this thread is not run, that time is_alive method will show false. So thread one, basically the thread is_alive method is used for executions of the thread, which is true or not. Now in another class, I have mentioned here that in main class, I have mentioned that we are creating, in main class, we're creating the object of the predefined user defined thread class, whichever I used, that is thread t1 equal to new thread one. Thread one t1 equal to new thread one. This is the object of this class. So in main class, we are creating the object of our thread class. And through this object, we call the start method. Whenever we will call the start method, this thread will start executing. This user defined thread class, which we have used, will run and execute. And then in try catch block, I have mentioned join method. So in here, you can see that how many threads are running. Thread one, which we have used as a predefined, which we have used as a thread one class, this thread and the main thread. This two thread are running in our example. One is main thread. We know that if anything first in any thread class, the main thread runs at first. So here in our example, there is a thread that is main thread, and another one is our user defined thread class, that is thread one. So two threads in our example, two threads are running. One is main thread and another one is this thread one. This two thread are running. So t1.join. Now t1 is the object of our user defined thread. Our user defined thread object is t1, and this object you calls the join method. So whenever this object calls the join method, that means the other thread execution will be stopped. In our example, what is the other thread? Other thread is our main thread. So the main thread execution will be stopped. So this statement system.out.println, this statement is of the main class, and this statement's execution will be stopped until this is completed, and after that this statement will be executed. So if we run this, you will see that cd documents, then Java C thread test 2.java. The program is correctly compiled, and then 2. Now you can see how many times our first, what happened? First, our thread class, our thread class object is created in the main class, and through this object start method is called. So this, whenever the start method is called, this thread runs. So this thread will run how many times? 0 to 5. So here you can see 0 to 5 means 6, total 6 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 times this thread runs, and isAlive method is used for showing that the thread is alive or not. So whenever the thread is running, that means it is alive. So it will, what it will return, this method will return true status. So that's why it is true status are mentioned. But you can see that in try catch block, in try block, I have mentioned t1.join. Now, whatever this t1 is the object of our user defined thread class. And through this user defined thread class object, we are calling join method. So what is the join method? What the join method do? Join method will, whenever in our example, thread one is a thread and main thread is another thread. So T1 is the object of our thread one. So thread one execution will be continued, but main thread execution will be stopped. And how many times and how many hours execution will be stopped? The execution will be stopped until thread one completes its execution. So this statement will not be executed, because this statement is of our main thread. So here you can see this statement is not first executed. After completion of the thread one, that means after completion of our thread one, this statement is executed. Now in this statement, you can see I have mentioned t1.isAlive means it will represent that isAlive is the object of the thread one, is alive or not, means the thread is alive or not. Now t1 is of whose object? Thread one. So it will return false value, because this statement will executed when? Is this statement will executed when thread one completes its execution. But here in this we are mentioning that t1.isAlive, but through this we are using that our thread one is alive or not. In this statement we are wants that the result should be that our thread one is alive or not. But here you can see this statement is executed at a time when the thread one is already stopped its execution. So here it will return false, because this statement will execute it when thread one completed its execution. But we are wanting that thread one is alive or not, that we are mentioning. So that's why the new status is represented as false. Clear? So that's why new status is written as false. Clear to everyone? किसी का कोई क्वेश्चन है? हम फिर एक बार इसको बोलेंगे या समझ में आ गया? कोई क्वेश्चन किसी का?
इनिट
अंकिता बोला। थोड़ा थोड़ा नेटवर्क का तुम्हारा इशू हो रहा है, थोड़ा ये करके बोलो, हम समझ नहीं पा रहे हैं तुम्हारा वॉइस।
ठीक
हम फिर बोलेंगे, तुम एक काम करो, चैट बॉक्स में लिखो, चैट बॉक्स में हम समझ जाएंगे, क्योंकि तुम्हारा वॉइस थोड़ा ब्रेक हो रहा है, हम समझ नहीं पा रहे। तुम चैट बॉक्स में लिखो, अंकिता तुम चैट बॉक्स में लिखो मुझे एक बार। मेन थिंग इज इन थ्रेड, इन आवर थ्रेड यू नो दैट द फर्स्ट थ्रेड व्हेन अ प्रोग्राम रन्स, द फर्स्ट थ्रेड रन इज मेन थ्रेड, द मेन थ्रेड रन्स एट फर्स्ट। सो इफ यू लुक इन दिस एग्जाम्पल, देयर इज टू थ्रेड प्रेजेंट, दैट इज वन थ्रेड, थ्रेड वन, दिस इज द यूजर डिफाइंड थ्रेड एंड अनदर वन इज मेन थ्रेड। सो इन आवर थ्रेड एनवायरमेंट, मल्टी थ्रेडिंग एनवायरमेंट, टू थ्रेड्स आर रनिंग, वन इज थ्रेड वन एंड अनदर इज मेन थ्रेड। नाउ इज अलाइव मेथड इज यूज फॉर टू नो दैट द थ्रेड इज अलाइव और नॉट, इज अलाइव मेथड टू नो द स्टेटस ऑफ द थ्रेड दैट इट इज अलाइव और नॉट। एंड जॉइन मेथड इज इफ देयर इज मल्टी थ्रेडिंग एनवायरमेंट, मल्टीपल थ्रेड्स आर रनिंग, इफ अ थ्रेड यूज द जॉइन मेथड देन द अदर थ्रेड्स एग्जीक्यूशन विल बी स्टॉप्ड, देन द अदर थ्रेड्स एग्जीक्यूशन विल बी स्टॉप्ड अंटिल द थ्रेड हुई जेनरेट द जॉइन मेथड इट्स एग्जीक्यूशन इज कंप्लीटेड, मीन्स द थ्रेड हुई जेनरेट जॉइन मेथड और विच कॉल्स द join method its execution will continue and other threads execution will be stopped. Now you can say how much time it will be stopped. It will be stopped until the thread which calls the join method its execution is completed. After completion of its execution the other threads will run again, and so that time the other threads will be paused when the thread which generate join method will be executing. So here in this example you see that in our multi-threading environment two threads are running, one is thread one and another one is our main thread. These two threads are running. Now you can see that in thread one, our user defined thread, we have mentioned public void run method. Our run method is mentioned, and this run method, there in this run method I have already here mentioned a loop. This loop is means the number of times the thread will be executed, and inside this loop is alive method is used, means this loop will execute it six times. So six times the status will be printed as a true, because isAlive method returns boolean status true or false. If the thread is alive, it returns true. If the thread is not alive, it returns false. So that's why it will return true or false value. So it is written inside the loop. That means the number of times the loop will be executed, it will be show that the thread is alive. So that's why status will be as a true. Now you can see in main method I have mentioned a try catch block, and inside this try catch block I have used a join method. Now in this join method you can see t1.join. t1.join, now t1 is the object of our user defined threat class. You can see T1 is the object of the user defined threat class. So our user defined threat class is generating join method. Our user defined threat class is using join method. That means the another thread in our multi-threading environment, the another thread is main thread. So our thread one is using join method. That means the other thread in our multi-threading environment, the other thread is main. So main thread execution will be stopped. So for main thread execution will be stopped means this statement, the last statement, this statement is of main class. So this statement's execution will be stopped. But when this statement's execution will be resumed after the completion of the thread one execution, this statement will execute. Now you can see whenever I run that, so first inside the main class, thread class object is created, and through this object, start method is called. After calling start method will call run method. So whenever the run method is called, the thread will start executing. Whenever the run method is called, the thread will start executing. And so there you can see that 0 to 5 means 6 times. So 6 times the status is printed because it is mentioned inside the loop. So 6 times the status is mentioned, and this is mentioned as a true. But after that, in that time, our thread class used join method. So at a particular time, our thread class used join method. So the execution of the another thread, that is main thread, its execution, it stopped. Its execution will be begin after completion of our user-defined thread class execution. So you can see after executing this total 6 times, the status is shown true, and then exit from thread one. So after the thread one executed, then this statement is executed because this statement is of basically used as a this statement is of main thread. So this statement is executed. But in this statement, I have tried to find out that if T1 is alive or not. But this statement is at a time this statement is executed, T1 is already stopped because T1 is the object of thread one, object. So this statement and this statement will execute in what time? Whenever the thread one execution is completed. So that's why new status is shown as false. Clear? Ankita?
Yes.
Up clear hai?
Yes, sir.
ठीक है. तो ये है हम लोगों का is alive and join method का काम. ठीक है. Next, और एक method को जो लेके हम discussions किए थे, और एक जो method हम लोगों का था, वो था हम लोगों का yield method. Yield method in thread. So now we'll see how this yield method will work. So now we'll see how this yield method works. Now, yield method is just the opposite case of a join method. But some constraints is mentioned that whichever thread calls the yield method, that thread's execution is stopped and the other thread execution will continue. But one thing you have in the mind, that the other threads, whichever the other threads are present, will be of the same priority. In that case, yield method will be perform execution. Otherwise, it is not possible. So in multi-threading environment, it should be taken in mind that the thread, it should be in mind that all the threads are present should be of same priority, and that time this yield method will work. Otherwise, the yield method will not work correctly. So, and whichever thread uses the yield method, its execution will be continued. Sorry, its execution will be stopped. Whichever thread uses the yield method, its execution will be stopped and the other thread's execution will continue. After the other thread's execution will completed, the thread which generate the yield method, its execution will continue. So here you can see I have uses two threads. One is A and one is B. And these two threads are extending predefined thread class. Now you can see in our first thread, it consumes yield method. That means if I in the loop I have mentioned I equal to 1, I less than 5, I plus plus. And if I equal to 2, then the yield method will be called. But in the other thread, in the case of other thread, the execution will continue as it is. So whenever our first thread, that is A, will consume, that means whenever the value I value will be 2, so yield method will be called and its execution will be stopped. It will again resume its execution after the B threads completed its execution. So if we run this program, you can see that first you have to go to the position in which it is stored, then Java C yield test dot Java. So the program is compiled and then now you can see Java yield test. Now you see first the thread is executed. One. So first time it is executed. Next, B is executed. B is 1. But after that, you couldn't see that the execution of this. You couldn't able to see the execution because it is stopped. It is stopped. It is that time. After completion of this, the execution will again start. So you can see the execution is started. Sorry. So you can see that after, whenever the yield method is called, the thread execution is stopped. Whenever the yield method is called, the thread execution is stopped. And after completion of the other thread's execution, after the execution of the other threads completed, then our thread A, it starts execution. So you can see that whenever we run this, the execution will be stopped. So this is the purpose of the yield test method. Clear? It is clear to everyone? Ankita? समझ में आया सब लोग को? और बाकी कुणाल रवि तुम लोग का? कुणाल रवि स्वाति शिवम?
यस सर।
ठीक है, तो this is all about the methods which are present in the thread, whichever I have told in your class, but I didn't able to run this program. So today I have based on this, I run the all the methods that are present in the threads. The execution, how it is executed, I have shown it today. Now, in string class also, in string class and string buffer class, I have also mentioned some topics. So if possible, I am trying it that I can able to show you. And if the time completed, then I will show the part which will be left in the next class. Okay. But I will show it today, the parts in the string and string buffer class, and whichever part will be left over, I will show it in the next class. Okay. So during one thing I will mention, that whenever if any of this method you have to in exam, you have to able to write any of this method in it is mentioned in your exam, then try to write this program with an example. If you write this program or write this using example, then it will carry some marks good, because the teacher will think that you understand it pretty well, and that's why you are write this with a program. First mention the method, whatever it is, it works, how it works, then write it the how it works, and after that mention it with a program, and then through this program explain the program correctly. It will carry good marks, because the teacher will think that he or she has a good knowledge about it. And that's why it is best that if you write the method, and writing them, after writing the method, you should use some small example in it. Then it will carry good marks. Okay. So I think today I will not able to show you the string class and string buffer class, but I am trying that if I able to show the string class example. So first, the string class example, today I will want to share you with the string class example. So first, the string class program, I will show you the string class program. Now, if you in the previous classes, I have mentioned the string program with you, that in this string program, first string in every other language, string is used as a characters. But in cases of the Java, string is used as an object. And this string object are created using two types. One is string literal, and another one is using new keyword. These two ways string can object can be created. So first in this program, you can see that inside the main, I have first used a string variable, or we can say used a string literal, string s1 equal to EEC. And then next, I have created a string object using, this string object is created using string literal, and this string object is uses created using new keyword. So string object mainly created, we can create string object using two types. One is string literal, and another one is using new keyword. Here first string s1 equal to eec. So s1, string literal s1, its value is eec. And in next, I have mentioned using new keyword, and using this new keyword, the string value s2 have the value classes. So s1 and s2, two are pointing to these values. So s1 contains eec and s2 contains this parameter value classes. S2 contains this. Now, if you remember in string, I have mentioned that whenever any value is stored, the JVM will first check it in the string constant pool. The JVM will check that the value is present in the string constant pool. If the value is present, already present in the string constant pool, it will directly refer to it to the, it will directly point to the reference of that of values. But if it is not stored previously, it is not stored, then the value will be stored in the string constant pool and the object will point to that. So EC, first value is EC. This is already not present in the string constant pool. So JVM will store this value in the string constant pool and S1 will point to the EC. Next, using new keyword, we are using new keyword, we are creating a string object. And in this string object, the S2 will point to the classes, because classes is also not present in the string constant pool. So classes value will be stored in the string. Classes value will be stored in the string constant pool, and S2 will point to it, classes. So whenever we use s1.concat, means string object dot concat method, easy classes, means this is the parameter we are want to concatenation with EC. And after that, we are printing the value of the S1. But you can see that the value is not changed. The value will not changed. You can see that the value will not changed. Dot Java, then Java string. Now, I have already used concatenation method, but you are seeing EC. This is because for EC classes are new in EC classes and EC are not same. So in string constant pool, EC classes value will be stored and another new memory reference will be created. So that's why it is using S1. It is not shown for using S1. We didn't able to show it because string has in string for this, a new value will be stored in the string constant pool. And for this new value, a new memory reference will be also created. That's why we all know string is immutable. So the values of the string remains constant throughout the program. Then how can we show that concatenation method works? Then we have to mention exponentially that s1 equal to s1.concatenate. Means we are explicitly performing this point that s1 will point to the new created, new value created. The value, new value created, it's directly point to that. Then we can able to show it. You can see that if we explicitly mention like this, that S1 will point to the new value, EC, EC classes. Then we will use the concatenation method. Then we can see this total values. You can see. Now you will see the EC, EC classes. So the memory pointer, we will have to be explicitly point to that location. Then we can see the new value. So that's why we call that string is immutable. We cannot able to change the string value. So here you can see for S1, EC, a new in JVM will create a new value in the string constant pool. For classes also, it will create a new value in the string constant pool. And easy classes, for concatenation, after concatenation, it will be easy classes. So easy classes and easy classes is not the easy, is not the same. So for that, again, a new value will be created and a new memory reference will be created. So that's why at first we didn't able to see it. But whenever we explicitly mention the memory pointer to point to that location, easy classes, then we able to see the output. But at first we didn't able to see the output for this reason. Clear? समझ में आ रहा है कि string का जो हम बताए थे कि जो concept हम class में बताए थे क्यों हम लोग उसको देख नहीं पाते हैं, यही उसका वजह है. समझ में आया? कोई क्वेश्चन है किसी का? Do you have anyone has any question? Ankita, Riya, Kunal. Anyone has any question?
No, sir.
Okay. I think that it is clear to everyone. The thing which I have mentioned in the class, today I am showing all of its program. Today I am showing the program, how it works. All the concepts I have mentioned in the classes.